So unit 2 includes the acid, base and redox reaction. So I have started with the first theory of acid and base, which is the Arrhenius concept of acid and base. So according to Arrhenius, acid is a substance which gives you the H plus ions when dissolved in water. So acid are those substances which gives you the H positive ion when dissolved in water. And base are those substances which gives you the OH minus ions when dissolved in water. So according to Arrhenius, an acid is a substance which when dissociate to give you the H positive ion when dissolved in water. So suppose I am going to take the example of HCl. So when HCl will going to dissolve in water, this will give you the H positive ion and Cl negative ion. Since it gives you the H positive ion, therefore it is a Arrhenius acid, or according to Arrhenius, it is a acid. Second, a base is a substance which gives you the OH minus ions or hydroxyl ion when dissolved in water. So suppose I am going to take the example of NaOH. NaOH is the sodium hydroxide. So NaOH dissociate as Na positive and OH negative. Since it gives you the OH minus ion, so it is a base. So according to Arrhenius, we have the acid which gives you the H positive ion, and base is a substance which gives you the OH minus ion. So it is a simple definition of acid and base. So next example is acetic acid. So acetic acid when dissolved in water gives you the H positive ion and CH3CO negative. So it is a negative part of this acid. So since it gives you the H positive ion, so it is an acid. Next example is calcium hydroxide. So calcium hydroxide, jab hum water mein dissolve karte hain, so it gives you the Ca2 positive ion and OH negative ion. Since it's also give you the OH minus ion, so it is also a base. Since here you have a term aqueous, it means the ions are hydrated or ions are surrounded by the water molecule. So according to Arrhenius, acid are the those substances which gives you the H plus ions, and base is the those substances which gives you the OH minus ions. A greater the number of H positive ion and OH negative ions, the stronger will be the acid or the base. So jo jitna jyada H positive ion furnish karega when dissolved in water, stronger will be the acid. Similarly, jo jitna jyada OH negative ion furnish karega when dissolved in water, stronger will be the base. Next concept is the concept of Lorentz and Boston. So according to this, acid is defined as a substance which has the higher tendency to donate the proton to any other substance. Proton is H positive. A base is the substance which has tendency to accept the proton from any other substance. So acid are the H positive donor, means jo kisi substance ko H positive donate kar de, aur base kaun se substance hote hain jo H positive ion kisi aur substance se accept kar le. So acid is the proton donor while base is the proton acceptor. So acid when dissolved in water, this will going to release the H positive ion, which is proton, and you left with the basic part of the acid. This base is known as the conjugate base, while this acid is known as the conjugate acid. So such pairs which can be formed from one another by the gain of loss of the proton are known as conjugate acid and base pair. So I am taking one a simple example of the HCl. So HCl is the acid, while hydrogen is going, water is going to act as the base in this case. So when HCl dissociates, this is going to dissociate as H positive ion and Cl negative ion. So this H positive ion is going to taken up by the water, and this water is going to convert into the H3O positive. So this H3O positive is conjugate acid, while this Cl negative is the conjugate base of that acid. So when HCl going to dissociate, this will going to give you the H positive ion. Since it going to give you the H positive ion, so it is a acid. While base कौन सा होता है जो उसी प्रोटॉन को एक्सेप्ट करता है. सो हेयर वॉटर विल गोइंग टू एक्सेप्ट दिस प्रोटॉन, देयरफॉर इट इज अ, अकॉर्डिंग टू रॉल्स एंड बॉस्टन, इट इज अ बेस. सो एसिड कौन से हैं जो प्रोटॉन डोनेट कर रहे हैं, और बेस कौन से हैं जो प्रोटॉन एक्सेप्ट कर रहे हैं. सो फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन थी हमारी अरहेनियस कॉन्सेप्ट. इसके अकॉर्डिंग भी एसिड कौन से होते हैं जो H पॉजिटिव आयन रिलीज करते हैं व्हेन डिसॉल्व्ड इन वाटर, और बेस कौन से होते हैं जो OH नेगेटिव आयन फर्निश करते हैं व्हेन डिसॉल्व्ड इन वाटर. व्हाइल इन द केस ऑफ फ्लोरेसेंट बॉस्टर, एसिड कौन से होते हैं जो H पॉजिटिव आयन डोनेट करते हैं, और बेस कौन से होते हैं जो H पॉजिटिव आयन एक्सेप्ट करते हैं. इन द केस ऑफ एसिटिक एसिड, acetic acid is also going to dissociate as CH3O negative and H positive. So this H positive will going to taken up by the water molecule, which is the base, since it will going to accept the proton from the acid. So it is the base, while this acetic acid is going to donate the H positive ion. So it is a acid. Water possesses the both the properties, means it will going to act as the acid as well as it will going to act as the base. So such substances which are going to act as the both acid and base are known as the amphoteric compounds. Since with the base, yahan pe ye base hai, theek hai, ammonia. So ammonia jo hai wo isse H positive ion accept कर रहा है. So water will going to dissociate as H positive and OH negative. So जो ये H positive donate कर रहा है, वही ये base accept कर रहा है, and this will going to convert into the NH4 positive. While जो यहाँ से acid का OH negative release हुआ था, वो हमारा as it is है. So जो acids होते हैं, उनका क्या बनता है H positive निकालने के बाद, conjugate base. और जो बेस होते हैं वो एच पॉजिटिव एक्सेप्ट करने के बाद क्या बनाते हैं हमारा, कॉन्जुगेट एसिड. सिमिलरली वी हैव HCl. सो HCl व्हेन रिएक्ट विद द वाटर, दिस विल गोइंग टू कन्वर्ट इनटू द H3O पॉजिटिव एंड यू लेफ्ट विद द Cl नेगेटिव. सिमिलरली H2O3 व्हिच इज द नाइट्रिक एसिड, सो दिस विल गोइंग टू गिव यू द H3O पॉजिटिव एंड NO3 negative. H2SO4 will going to first, in the first step, it will going to give you the H3O positive and HSO4 negative. Again this HSO4 react with the water to give you the H3O positive and SO4 negative. So since this H2SO4 dissociate in two steps, therefore it is known as the diprotic acid. So we have term monoprotic acid, diprotic acid, polyprotic acid and so on. So monoprotic acids kaun se hote hain jo ek H plus ion release karte hain when dissolved in water. ठीक है, डाइप्रोटिक एसिड्स आर दोज एसिड विच आर गोइंग टू रिलीज टू एच पॉजिटिव आयंस. ट्राइप्रोटिक एसिड विच आर गोइंग टू रिलीज 3H प्लस आयंस. सो एग्जांपल इज फॉस्फोरिक एसिड विच इज H3O H3PO4. So when this dissolves in water, this is going to give you the 3H plus ions and PO4 3 negative. So since this is going to give you the 3H plus ions, so it is a triprotic acid. So monoprotic acid ke baad humare jitne bhi acids hain, they are collectively known as the polyprotic acid. So polyprotic acid are those acids which releases 2 to n number of H plus ions when dissolved in water. So monoprotic acid gives you the 1 H plus ion when dissolved in water. Diprotic acid gives you the 2 H plus ions when dissolved in water. Phosphoric acid is a triprotic acid which gives you the 3 H plus ions when dissolved in water. Similarly, we have HCl. So HCl will going to dissociate as H positive and CN negative. So this H positive is going to be taken up by the water molecule and converted into the H3O positive and CN negative. Here we have the ammonium ions. Ammonium ion will going to release H plus ion and itself converted into the ammonia, and you left with the H3O positive. H3O positive is also known as the hydronium ion. Now the strength of the acid and base. So strength of the acid depends upon the tendency to lose proton, while strength of the base is the tendency to accept the protons. So jo jitna jaldi accept karta hai proton ko, wo utna zyada hi strong as base hai, aur jo jitni jaldi lose karta hai proton ko, wo itna hi strong acid hai. So since we have two examples, one is the HCl, which is the hydrochloric acid, and another one is the CH3COO negative OH, which is the acetic acid. So HCl jo hai wo bahut hi fast rate se apna H plus ions donate kar deta hai. So it is a very strong acid, while acetic acid is a weak acid since this will not release whole of the H plus ions. Means wo completely dissociate nahi hota hai, ye partially dissociate hota hai. To ye aapka weak acid hai, since it is not going to punish whole of the H plus ions. It will going to dissociate partially, or partially this will going to dissociate partially. So acetic acid is a weak acid, while hydrochloric acid is a strong acid. We have a general rule: stronger the base, weaker the conjugate base. Jo jitna jyada strong acid hoga, uska jo ye conjugate base ban raha hai yahan pe, wo utna jyada weak hoga. Like in the case of acetic acid, ye aapka weak acid hai, to jo aapka iska base ban raha hai, which is the acetate ion, wo utna hi jyada strong base hai. ठीक है, HCl will going to dissociate to give you the Cl minus ion. तो ये आपका weak conjugate base है, while acetate ion is the strong conjugate base. Now move to the Lewis concept of acid and base. So according to Lewis, acid is a species that is capable for the accepting the electron pair to form a covalent bond, while base is a species that is capable of the donating the electron pair to form a covalent bond. So let's take the example of BF3. So BF3 is now going to act as the acid, since this will going to accept the electron pair from the ammonia. तो अमोनिया क्या कर रहा है, अपना इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर डोनेट कर रहा है, वाइल BF3 जो आपका एसिड है ये क्या कर रहा है, ये इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर एक्सेप्ट कर रहा है. सो एसिड्स इज अ स्पीशीज व्हिच आर गोइंग टू एक्सेप्ट द पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, और बेस कौन से होते हैं जो डोनेट करते हैं पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो यहाँ पे जो आपका BF3 है ये एक एसिड है. since it is going to accept the electron pair from ammonia, तो अमोनिया क्या कर रहा है, अपना इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर डोनेट कर रहा है, सो इट इज अ बेस. सो इन दिस केस BF3 इज एक्ट एज द एसिड व्हाइल अमोनिया इज एक्ट एज द बेस एंड दे विल गोइंग टू फॉर्म द कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड बिटवीन BF3 एंड अमोनिया. सिमिलरली नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल BF3 एंड F नेगेटिव. So here F negative is going to donate its electron pair to the BF3. So it is a base while BF3 is going to accept the electron pair from the F negative. So it is act as the acid. Here some of the acid which are present in the nature, like we have the acetic acid present in the vinegar. फॉर्मिक एसिड प्रेजेंट इन दी आंट स्ट्रिंग. तो जब आंट हमें बाइट कर लेती है सो वी हैव दी इचिंग. सो इचिंग इज ड्यू टू दी फॉर्मिक एसिड ओनली. सो सिट्रिक एसिड इज प्रेजेंट इन दी सिट्रस फूड लाइक वी हैव ऑरेंज लेमन एक्सेट्रा. लैक्टिक एसिड इज प्रेजेंट इन कर्ड. ऑक्सैलिक एसिड इज प्रेजेंट इन स्पेनिज. Ascorbic acid, which is nothing but the vitamin C, which is present in amla and citrus food. Tartaric acid is present in tamarind, grapes, and unripe mangoes. So they all have the sour taste, means they are khatte. So these all means acidic acids have the sour in taste, while there are some of the base. We have calcium hydroxide, which is present in lime water. Ammonia hydroxide, which is present in window cleaner. We have choline. So choline is contains the ammonium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxides are the content of the soap. Milk of magnesia is nothing but the magnesium hydroxide. So when we have the acidity, so doctor is going to prescribe the milk of magnesia. So we are going to take the mild base to neutralize the extra acid which is secreted by our stomach. Similarly, Eno contains the salts of sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate. So they are the also the weak base. So they are also going to neutralize the excess acid which is generated by our body or which is secreted by our body. Next is the neutralization reaction. So neutralization reaction is carried out when we are going to react an acid with an alkali. Alkali is nothing but the soluble base. So it is going to proceed with the formation of salt and water. So when acid and base are going to react with each other, they are going to form salt and water. So in this, acid is going to furnish H plus ion, base are going to furnish OH minus ion. So when acid is going to react with the base, these are going to form these two molecules, means H positive and OH negative are going to react with each other to form the water. And jo aapka positive part hai base ka aur jo negative part hai acid ka, they will going to react with each other to form a salt. So neutralization is reaction is nothing but when acid and react base is going to react with each other to going to give you the a salt and water as the product. So at the end of this reaction, we left with the neutral product, neutral solution. So in neutralization reaction, there is a combination of H plus ions and OH minus ions, which are going to react with each other to give you the water. And neutralization reaction is nothing but the acid-base neutralization reaction. So when HCl going to react with the NaOH, since it is a strong acid, means HCl is a strong acid and NaOH is a strong base. So this reaction is between the strong acid and the strong base. So when strong acid and strong base, they are going to give you the NaCl as the salt, which is nothing but the sodium chloride, which is also known as the table salt. So NaCl is sodium chloride and we left with the water. So sodium chloride is the salt and we left with the water. Second reaction is the between the weak acid and the strong base. So here is the example of weak acid is the oxalic acid. Strong base, again we are going to use the sodium hydroxide. So when these two are react, they will going to form salt and water. So they are going to form salt and water. So here sodium oxalate is the salt and we have the water. So since as we know oxalic acid is a diprotic acid, since it is going to refurnish two H plus ions. So we need two molecules of sodium hydroxide to for the complete neutralization of the oxalic acid. So oxalic acid gives you the 2H plus ion. So here we left with the two molecules of water since and left with the sodium oxalate. Next reaction is the between the sodium carbonate and hydrochloric acid. So sodium carbonate is the weak base while hydrochloric acid is the strong acid. So next reaction between the weak base and the strong acid. So sodium carbonate first react with the hydrochloric acid to give you the NaCl, water and carbon dioxide. So sodium carbonate is nothing but the washing soda. Common name is the washing soda. So when sodium carbonate reacts with the hydrochloric acid, gives you the sodium chloride, water and CO2. This is the NaSCO3, which is sodium bicarbonate. So when sodium bicarbonate reacts with the HCl to give you the NaCl, water and CO2. So here sodium bicarbonate is nothing but the baking soda. So when you will see the effervescence when you mix the baking soda in food items, so effervescence is due to this carbon dioxide only.